Greetings! Today we will proceed to the Tizen development part of the application for SAP. If you haven't created your Android part of the application, please refer to the first video of the series. First off, a recap of the first episode. Last time we introduced the Samsung Accessory Protocol, gathered what we'll be requiring, and created a sample Android part of the project using the Accessory SDK. And today we will be creating the Tizen part of the application that would communicate through the Samsung Accessory Protocol. Let's begin. First, let's open the Tizen IDE for wearable and select a workspace. Go ahead and close the tip of the day and let's create a new project. Select File, New, and Tizen Wearable Web Project. Select Template, Basic, and I will name this one Simple SAP Consumer, which is an alternative to the Android application Simple SAP Provider. This will be the one to receive the communication from the Android side. Now we have a project we can work with. First, let's modify the user interface. Let's change the title to SAP Consumer. And I created a UI ahead of time for this. I just delete this, put that instead. So now we have a title that says SAP Consumer. We have three buttons on top, namely Connect, Fetch, and Disconnect, that each have a function. And the last values are for the styles of the button. In this division tag, this will display all the communication messages received from the Android device. Next, let's add the script functionality. So open the JS folder, double click main.js. You will have a function here for closing the application. Just delete this. You won't be needing this for now. Then let's add four variables. So the first variable is the SA agent. This will be mirroring the SA agent in the Android side. Let's initialize it to null. And a variable for the SA socket, also mirroring the Android side socket, also initialized null, and a channel ID. Make sure to initialize this to the channel ID same as the Android side. And the provider name. The name of your provider application is the name of the Android side application. So for us, it's Simple SAP Provider. Next, let's add a content writer. Type this ahead of time. So basically, this function, create HTML, accepts a parameter, like so, and writes it on the result board, reference to the index.html object, and adds logs there. Next, let's add another function. And this function is for error logging. As you can see, it logs errors on the console in your IDE. Let's add a variable for the agent callback. So, typed it ahead of time as well. So basically what this does is that it is responsible for connection to the Android side and alerts you that a connection has been established. Let's add another variable for the agent find callback. So what this one does is that it locates the peer using the SAMHSA accessory protocol that have a certain provider app name. Let's add another function, name it onSuccess, to handle the success response of connection from the agent and the peer. This is the alternative to the onError. Now let's add another function to write the result to our HTML board. So I type in function onReceive that accepts a channel ID and data. This function will be calling the createHTML function, which logs in the data received. This one mirrors the onReceive function from the Android side application. Now let's add the button methods. First, for the connect. So as you may see, over here, the if statement checks if the SA socket is already connected. If it is, an alert shows up that it is already connected. If not, we use the web APIs to request a connection from the SA agent that returns a success or an error, and log to catch the errors. Next is the fetch method, which gets the data from the Android side, like so. So right here, we send the data to the Android side channel ID, which is defined, and an empty string. And the last button function is disconnect to proactively disconnect your wearable and your Android device. So in this first if statement, we check if the SA socket is not null. Console logs disconnect socket is not null, of course, and proactively sends a close to the connection. Else, there's an error. And the last that we have to add is a script for us to be able to close the application. Recall that we removed a script earlier, so we're just going to add that down here with a reference to the close function of the Tizen hardware key. If you want to add some styles to your application, just go ahead and modify the style.css file. So for this application, I'll just modify basic, and I'll change the body background to white and add a style rule for the title. So basically, our title will be now colored blue, font size of 24 pixels, and the rest is for spacing. Similar to the Android side, we will be needing metadata for Tizen as well. Think of this as the common ground where the two technologies meet. In the project folder, right click, let's add folder named res. Inside res, add another folder named XML. As you can see, this is similar to the Android side. And we'll be also adding an XML file inside. Recall the name of the XML file that you named your Android side. So for me, it's sapservices.xml. Click finish, and you now have the file inside. It's okay if it says unsupported file. We will be modifying this. Now that we have the metadata XML file in place, all we have to do is put contents into it. So to speed things up, let's go to the Android development and let's copy the XML data over here, paste that over there, and let's just simply modify it. For the name, let's change provider to consumer, and this should stay the same for the ID and the name. The role will change to consumer as well, and and remove the reference to the service implementation. This is only important for the Android side. And for the version, just change it 2.0. Transport Wi-Fi and everything else should stay the same. Now we have a working metadata in our side. What's left is the modification of our config file. Let's open the config.xml file. And right before the name tag, let's add the reference to the metadata we created. So just like the Android side, we name it accessory service location, and the content of the value is where the file is placed. And after that, we just add a privilege for our widget to be able to use the accessory protocol like so. So now we have the config file set up for SAP use, and that's about it for coding. Now that we have everything in place, let's just build the project. So click on project and build. Now this will produce a .wgt file. This is the file we will need to attach it to the Android side. For a review, let's have a recap of the best practices in Tizen development part of the application for SAP. First, create a bare application with basic UI. Second, don't forget to add scripting for SAP functionality. Third, remember to add the metadata. And fourth, modify the config file for permission to use SAP and add the reference to the metadata. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Stay tuned for our next video. Thanks for watching.